Okay, what up, world? Like I told y'all before, man, like I told y'all like 2-3 videos ago, more mixtape reviews, B.O.B., fucking We Ball. It dropped last week. It's B.O.B.'s first release of material since Strange Clouds came out. Man, so let's get right into it, man. Track number one is a skit. It's, you know what I'm saying, it's intro. It's a fucking We Ball intro, man. Barack Obama, somebody doing an Obama impression. Just doing an intro. You go by the same breed, fucking We Ball. 40 seconds. I mean, it's funny. It sounds just like the president. Track two, Stall Campaign. It's got Playboy Trey on it. And they just talking about doing it big, man, doing it presidential. And I mean, not a lot more needs to be said, man. Playboy Trey had a couple silly lines. B.O.B. delivery is always dope. So track number three is called Dynamite. B.O.B. talking about smoking, talking about being shit. I mean, that's what most rappers do. And Track number four, Still In This Bitch. Still In This Bitch features T.I., it features Juicy J. And B.O.B. talking about just running shit wherever he go. And then T.I., man, I was skeptical about hearing T.I. since he really ain't dropped a lot of shit since he got out of jail. He got out of jail like a year already, right? T.I. got a new album out, coming out next month. It's called Trouble Man. I seen the cover. He really covering a track with, I don't know, man. I'm skeptical about new T.I. material. Cause, I don't know, I'm skeptical, like, I can't even define why. I mean, we'll figure out when the album come out, man. I wasn't impressed by the features. But yeah, this B.O.B., you talk about T.I. and so we, Juicy J is also on this. And just like in my Wiz review, man, Juicy J, he talking about splurging, he talking about fucking bitches, he talking about riding in the cars with the top down. Track number four. My bad, track number five.
Let's do it.
Curtis Snow.
It's real Curtis Snow, you know what I mean? From the real bluff,
I mean, that's
you know
what
I mean?
That is. A minute.
Heard
of Curtis
might
Snow
not
talking.
Seen Snow in the Bluff, the movie.
I don't know who Curtis Snow is.
Fuck with it. It's on iTunes. It's on Netflix. It's at Walmart. It's bootleg. It's all over the world, you know what I mean? It's some real shit, man. They need to be seen. You know what I'm talking about? They try to have this shit.
Track number six is called Fucking We Ball. The title track to the mixtape, Fucking We Ball. Man, just clowning. Shutting shit down. Spody is also on this. It's kind of boring, man. I mean, he really wasn't talking about this. His delivery is real monotone. And, I mean, really all I can say about fucking We Ball. So, track seven is called Be There. And, it's got a real, real pop. Red for radio sound to the shit. It sound like a Strange Clouds throwaway. Should have didn't make the album. And I mean, B.O.B. really just talking about having this girl back. Track 8 is called Everything. And B.O.B. is just going in on this. His delivery is tight, his lyrics are tight, he's just rapping. Sometimes those are the better tracks, you know, somebody go in the booth and blank out. You know what I'm saying? For like, I don't know, 3.5 minutes. You know what I'm saying? Layer 16, drop the hood. Layer 16, drop the hood. Like, sometimes I like to have topics, and sometimes I like to just pop off. And it sounds like that's what B.O.B. did on this. They bring me to track number 9. Track number 9 is called All Right. And, B.O.B. talking about weak ass dudes, talking about hoes down for fuck. And, I mean, it's cool. It's cool. It's nothing. It's nothing extremely major. You know what I'm saying? Track number 10 is a Playboy Trace skit.
What's going on, man?
Chillin'.
And he's on the phone.
You met a club the other night, man. You know, we good. I know you beat that up, man.
Hell no.
I mean, it was funny, man. I was like,
all the time you invested in her, man, you ain't beat that, yeah?
I don't know if you got that.
Yeah, you tripping, man. Call her right now, man.
Playboy
Trace
is like,
yeah, she can call her. Right. She probably
from the movie ATL, you know what I'm saying?
Some on the voicemail right quick.
It was funny. That's the one that reminded me of. And it segues into track number 11. Track number 11 is "You Don't Give a Fuck." And that track right there, it really needs no breakdown. It really needs no explanation. When you don't give a fuck, you already know what that song is about. But once again, man, like, it's on some pop type shit, man. It's on some radio friendly shit. I mean, radio ain't gonna play no song called "When You Don't Give a Fuck." It might, "When You Don't Give a Fuck." When you gonna let me hang out with you? When you gonna let me come through and hold your hand? You know what I'm saying? That's what radio is on these days. Yeah, like the beat just sounds real radio friendly. That brings me to track number 12. Track number 12 is called "Best Friend." It features Iggy Azalea. And Mac Miller is on it too. Each verse, like B.O.B. verse, Iggy verse, Mac Miller verse, they just talk about a chick and basically the shit she get away with to get what she wants. And B.O.B. verse is cool. The hook is annoying as fuck. And Iggy Azalea. I'm gonna come off like a hater, like a motherfucker. But I mean, fuck it. Give me hate. If I'm not mistaken, chick is Australian, right? You know what I'm saying? Had to call the voice note right there. But yeah, for real though, I don't know, she sounds like, I don't want to say she sounds good, she sounds like damn near real ratchet though. Like, I don't like her delivery, I don't, on this song, this is the only track I ever heard of shit, I didn't like it, I wasn't feeling it. Just her verse, and she on the hook, and then towards the end of the song, she has like a little monologue where she's talking, and that's when you hear her Australian, you know, her accent and dialect and shit, but her delivery is like, I can't even place what it sounds like, you know what I mean? Like, I'm from Indianapolis, Indiana, so maybe motherfuckers feel the same way about me. Cause I be getting asked where I'm from, like, motherfuckers have asked if I'm from California, if I'm from New York, if I'm from the South. I'm from Indianapolis, Indiana, you know what I'm saying? East side. So, I don't know, man. I just wasn't feeling it. So, my man Mac Miller, man. Mac Miller is dope to me. He had the best verse on this track. But his delivery was also different from his usual, so it was more laid back. And he was rapping. So, track number 13, "Re-Love." This song threw me off for a little bit, you know what I mean? Because at first, like, I really couldn't place, like, it was another track where B.O.B. was just rapping on. And it was like, the focus really wasn't there. But, you know what I'm saying? He's talking about catering to the chicks, you know what I'm saying? And, it's another poppy radio track. Basically. So, track 14, got Snoop on it. Track 14 is called "Soul Below," with Snoop and B.O.B. on the track called "Soul Below." Do I really need to talk about what they're talking about? Because you already know what they're talking about, so you all know what I'm talking about. You know what I'm saying? If you don't know what they're talking about, they're talking about burning, they're talking about the dream, you know what I'm saying? The Mary Jane. Track number 15 is called "Spend It." And this is another track where I don't know where B.O.B. focus was, because At first, he's talking about spending time with his chick. And then toward the end of the verse, he just flips it and smashes it. And the hook sounded like the shit that he wanted Bruno Mars on, but he didn't hear Bruno Mars on. And then track 16 is Kevin Hart's beat. Anything Kevin Hart do, cut, say, is funny as fuck. Once again, didn't disappoint. 59 seconds of Kevin Hart trying to get a B.O.B. about why didn't he put my boy on the list. It took a lot for me to get him to call you. It was hilarious. I was rolling. Speaking of rolling, track 17, roll one up. Once again, just like So Blow, roll one up is a smoker track. You talking about chilling, like looking at the ceiling and shit, watching the fan go around. So you gonna blaze one up. And then last track, track 18, Hell of a Night. I mean, some of these titles are so self-explanatory, I need not go into them. But for the sake of being on video, Hell of a Night, you know what I'm saying? Going out, just clowning, just having a good ass time. What more needs to be said? B.O.B., fuck when we ball. It just, I had hopes for it. I wanted it to be dope. I wanted it to be diggity dope. But that's just not how I felt. You know what I'm saying? I feel like it had a lot of Strange Clouds throwaways. Like, shit, he wanted the Strange Clouds, and they didn't make the cut. But some of these tracks is better than what was on Strange Clouds. Strange Clouds wasn't leaked, though. It was great. Just like this fucking mixtape. You know what I'm saying? Just, I wasn't feeling some of the beats. I feel like B.O.B. focus wasn't there lyrically on some. His delivery and his wordplay is killing a lot of motherfuckers in the game. But, you know what I'm saying? Some of these tracks are just not tight to me. And then a lot of it sounded like it was all groomed for radio. Like, The Adventures of Bobby Ray had a lot of pop shit. And it had a lot of dope shit. It was a change of pace. It was different for when it came out 2 years ago. See, ever since I heard Strange Cloud, it was like his shit was more radio friendly, a little watered down, and just, I don't know, wasn't as dope as his debut. So, you know what I'm saying? Before I roll out, Fabolous Soul Tape 2 review coming soon. Joe Budden, a Loose Quarter review mixtape coming soon. I want to go see Rise of the Guardian. I'm going to drop some more raps. Go through my playlist. Man, I updated my playlist. I broke them down by year when it comes to the raps, when it comes to the reviews. So check my shit out, man. Like, subscribe, comment, positive or negative, man. I take it all in stride, man. So peace out.